chosen to pursue the cult, or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play. Shadows on the wall of a cave, an echo of the true events that happened somewhere else. Was I there to watch the shadows, or was I a shadow too? In a performance set up for someone else.
Scratch was closing in, gaining control. I couldn't let him escape the dark place. I had to keep him from Alice. I needed to get inside the manuscript. Alice. Alice had turned the bathroom into a dark room.
For months after Ellen died, I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion, the shock, the guilt, fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. He still checks in, even after he moved out west.
Alice's work had consumed the apartment. Her whole life.
One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image. The horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera. There was something in the dark, something I needed to see, to show. The more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for. Against reality. Faces in the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Full manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end.
Thank you. Some say that it moves forever this road, that I lose you on every time. Some say that it moves forever this road. For you I see, wake up, it's only a dream, on a winding road. Now they're in my bed, in the dark chamber of my head, I flip you over until you bend, this winding road. Don't you ever let me go, forever. Play and pretend forever, never, ever, won't ever to end. This message that you send to this winding road, it's just the beginning, only the ending.
Scratch stopped me before I could finish my edits to the manuscript. The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice. I needed a new draft of the story, one that would get me ahead of Scratch. Zane had said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation. It was locked from the other side.
I don't have time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake. It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask, but you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through. You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people helping you. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
Alice. I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is. Because of you. And so is someone important to me, someone you pulled into this. You keep opening doors, peeking in, reaching through to get what you want, and that puts you in my path.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This has gone on long enough. This and our Night Springs, it was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer here.
The next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different. And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
Whatever you say.
Dor, Zane, the masks were finally coming off. Was it a sign I was closer to escaping? I had no time to waste. The door was locked.
Of the tunnel.
Jumalauta, that held you close, Tom. Ei muuta kuin onward, set the granny in the snow. When the panic is biggest, the help is also near.
Dor didn't seem happy to see me this time.
Fearing the master is the root of wisdom. But don't let the game get you down. He's playing his role. Maybe put him in your films, Tom, like you have put me. Herkele, sehän olisikin.
What films?
I'm a fan of your masterworks. There is Tom the Poet, my favorite. And Yö den Yö is the most famous one, of course. And is it true what I hear? That it's coming back to cinemas soon. Is there a bottom to this rumor?
I need to get back to my apartment. Can you help me?
Well, planned is half done. You asked me to make sure you won't forget mikä se valokuva oli? The light pictures. The photos you artist wife took. They are waiting in the shoebox in the basement. What you leave behind, you find in front of you.
Okay. Thanks, Adi.
Couldn't force it open.
Wait. looking for war to sing Udenue in the cinema. But first, I work. And the work won't end even when you do it, Merkel. Ah, hey, Sina. One potato at a time. Just remember, Tom, the brave will eat the pea soup.
I would find Alice's photos in a shoebox. These were Alice's photos. I recognized the style. One showed the clicker sinking into darkness. The other showed a light in the shape of a bullet. They were important, even if I didn't know what to do with them yet.
Light is a poisonous, poisonous dart. Forever seeking out the darkest part. Forever, forever, forever.
I'm drowning. I'm trying to way out. There's no way out. It's deeper. This is hell. I'm in hell. I died. I wish I was dead. Let me die. I just want to sleep. Please. Let me sleep. I'm so tired. I just want to go home. I've written so much. I write. There's nothing left. It's all gone. I don't know how to write. All the words are gone. There's no more words. Where did they go? Did I eat the words? I recognize these words. You are the words moving. This is familiar. Oh, this is familiar. I've been here before. Have I said this before? I made this stuff. Where am I? Who am I? Wait. That's a strange name. Wait, that sounds like a character's name. I write that name up. I make that one name up. I want to be a character. I want to be the story. Just write this out of this stuff already. Ram these words down your throat. Let you choke on these words. Mine are words. Secret words. You can't take the words. I eat the words. These are my words. Stop using the words. The words. Alpha, the word. This isn't your story. It never was your story. The story is a monster. The story will eat you alive. The darkness is coming. The darkness inside. This is my story. You're in my story. Get out of my story. You are a character in my story. You can't stop the story. This story will go on forever. There's no escape. You will never escape. You won't drown here. You're stuck in a room.
To get to Parliament Tower, I needed to find a murder site. Zane would know where to find one.
Trails I was chasing the cult through, I ran into the filmmaker, Thomas Zane, an esoteric bohemian with a hard-on for acts of cruelty performed in the name of occult nonsense. A director wants to control every aspect of the world in their films. Is the cult leader any different? Was Zane just another alias for scratch. There was a rumor that Wake and Zane had been working on something together. I was gonna get the truth out of Zane with whatever means necessary.
Zane's room, 665, was upstairs. The elevator would take me there. Something told me Zane wouldn't be happy to see me this time.